where Cam Hopton is situated in a very beautiful area, we are built on a hill. And so all the water gushes down the hill, and we have a very flooded playground. We had a very flooded playground for a lot of the year.
So 18, 20 months ago, when we first came to the school, this was a swimming pool of water.
When it got extremely muddy, we can't use the field, we couldn't use a lot of the other grounds. The children were caked in mud. It has implications for our building, yeah. Difficulties for parents.
What was this like before this work had been done?
We couldn't play on it because it was too wet and muddy, and we'd end up coming in and trading mud through the school.
And how are others tackling this?
It is a real problem, some of these schools, and you know, I'm delighted, you know, that Cam Hopton has worked with Severn Trent in this way with a project.
So like they came in at the same time.
It's because there's no water.
Exactly.
Oh, so they don't have water.
This is what Severn Trent are giving you.
So we've designed some natural features that you've seen with the children earlier, so some rain gardens and some planters, and that collects the rainfall and effectively mimics nature. So it allows water to infiltrate slowly back into the ground, and also then overflow at a controlled rate back into Severn Trent's network, which helps to reduce that peak floody response.
My guess is it's cost quite a bit of money. How was that managed?
And that was part of the attraction, was that so Severn Trent would fully fund it all.
And Emma, it's really good to have you here from Severn Trent.
Today to be standing here and knowing that planter and all these features have done their job.
So that's kind of a real sense of satisfaction in that, of making that. I mean, it makes a difference to the lives of the children and parents and carers, but actually much more widely in the community, the way in which water is managed.
It matters for the environment because of all these plants in the summertime. They grow really beautiful and I really like them, and they attract nature as well, which is very nice.
Happier children, happier staff, happy parents and carers.
Yes, and we've got a river running at the bottom, so happier river too, because the water, what happens with the water draining out of here?
It drains out from the rainwater gardens down the hill and into the water
and
river over there.
And the gardeners actually filter the water too, so it's helping the offflow into the rivers and streams too.
As the parish priest here, why does it matter that we do these things?
Well, it's really important. God asks us to be good stewards of the world that he's created. And I think here at Cam Hopton, they've shown that they are putting that into action.
In 15, 20 years' time, what do you think, what are we going to have to be contending with then?
I think 15, 20 years' time, we've got to have learned how to make space for water. We need to not be fighting against nature and just concreting and building wherever we want. I think we need to be working with nature and really harnessing nature's power to try and solve the problems that effectively have been created over the past 200 years of industrialisation.
We'd be very keen to work with Severn Trent in similar projects, as well as supporting schools with other ways to reduce their flooding in areas to improve what they've actually sort of how they want to use their schools.
What do you think about it?
We love it!